Hey, what's up, guys? I want to talk to you about putting the Bible into your soul, renewing your mind with the Word of God, okay? I want to show you this whiteboard right here, this drawing, and I want to tell you what it means, okay? So check it out. So you see this? This is the solution. This is the biblical model of how to walk like Jesus and please God, okay? See, a lot of people have the issue. They say, how do I do good works? How do I bear good fruit if I have sinful flesh? Sinful flesh, right? How do I do this if I'm always thinking about evil things, evil thoughts, sinful memories? And this is the model. This is the new man. This is us. These are Christians right here. And I'm going to tell you how to do this, okay? So, again, this is the Christian model. Okay, so Jesus said, right? Jesus said that out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks, right? Jesus said, right, that you must be born again. Why? Because he said once we're born again, we receive his Spirit. And what does the Bible say about the Holy Spirit? That we are to be led by the Holy Spirit, and that he will what? That by the Spirit, we can put to death the deeds, the works, the desires, the lust, the gratifications of the flesh, the sinful flesh that we still have, right? When we got born again, we didn't lose this flesh. So let me show you this. Check it out real quick. So this is the Spirit, the answer, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ, the Spirit of our Father inside of us. This is him. This is our soul, our minds, right? Our will, our emotion, our memory, our habits. All these right here, in our mind, our soul. And this is our flesh. This cannot change until we die and we receive a new body, a glorified body, a renewed body, immortal body. But you see, it says 3, it says 2, and it says 1. Here's the first step. We got to get the Word of God, the truth of who we now are in Christ, of who God is, of what God told us to do, not to do, of his instructions, his commandments, his will, his ways, his plan, what's righteous, what's not, right? We got to get the Bible into our minds, into our souls, and renew our souls with it, right? Why? Because this is where we make our decisions from. You might say, what? Then why do we need the Holy Spirit? Because this needs to be in agreement with this in order to submit to this, to the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit within, right? It's only when this knows this and agrees with the Bible, with the Word of God, that we can start submitting to the Spirit and resisting, right, the devil, or denying the flesh, right? Whatever the temptation is. If we can get this in our minds, the Bible into our minds, and start agreeing with it and wanting it in our lives and start making decisions according to the Bible, then we're going to submit to the Spirit and allow the Spirit to live through us. That's why it says to be led by the Spirit, right? We got to submit, yield to the Spirit. And by doing that, by what? By submitting to God, we can resist the devil and we can deny the desires of our flesh. We can overcome temptation. If we manage to say yes to God by getting his truth in us and renewing our souls with it, submitting to the Spirit, we can use our bodies for good and we don't have to use it for evil. That's why the Bible says that by the Spirit, we can put to death the deeds of the flesh. And the Bible says that we can use our bodily members as instruments of righteousness, not as instruments of unrighteousness to sin, right? So what happens when we use our body for good, for righteousness? We have good works. We have good works. See, a lot of people have a problem understanding that as Christians, that before we go to heaven, we can do good works and bear good fruit. They have a problem understanding that because they think we're saying, oh, you're saved by good works. That's not what we're saying. We're saying once we are born again, we receive the Spirit of God, we have to submit to him and renew our minds, and we will do good works. That's why Jesus said, let your good works be seen among men. Let your light shine, and that's how you glorify God. Amen. So this is the biblical formula, renewing our minds, our souls with the Bible, with the truth, Word of God,
right? Submitting to God, to the Spirit, and using our lives, our bodies as living sacrifices, bearing good fruit, doing good works to the Lord. That's how we glorify Him. That's how we please Him. And that's how we look like Jesus. That's the Christian life, guys. So get the Bible into your souls. Renew your minds with the Word of God. Listen, your flesh shouldn't tell you what to do. The Spirit should tell you what to do. And the only way you will decide to submit to the Spirit and you will listen to the Spirit is if you're spiritually minded. That means if you're thinking according to the Bible. So get the Bible into your souls. Share this video, like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and tell your brother and sister to renew their minds, because there's no way to please God unless we're walking in the Spirit. The Bible says, he who walks in the flesh cannot please God. Listen, if we want to please God, we must walk in the Spirit. If we want to walk in the Spirit, we must get this, the Bible, into our souls, into our minds, so that we can submit to the Spirit. Amen. Let's grow. Bless you guys.